सिप राजू, सिप गिरीश, सिप सुदीप, सिप कुमार स्वामी, सिप रईस, सिप समिता, सिप रू माता जी, सिप आत्मात्रय, सिप गौतम, सिप मोक्तुल आनंद, सिप रूप, सिप रेखा, सिप सगैराज, सिप गौरीश, सिप सिप कौमुदी, सिप कोमल, सिप पार्वती अम्मा, सिप दासी, वेलकम टू दिस अमेजिंग संडे इवनिंग कॉल ऑफ व्हाट आई कॉल्ड अ डोज ऑफ नरिशमेंट, अ डोज ऑफ स्पिरिचुअल नरिशमेंट फॉर मी. Coming to you is like I used to go to my Guruji and spend some time with him, getting darshan from all of you and getting the opportunity to have this discussion on life, on spirituality. It's truly amazing because it is a way to bliss, to peace, to ananda. So we are here every day to get onto this subject. And I think some of you are ready with question answers, but the question that faces us today is a question we have put up. Do you believe that suffering is optional? Is it an option? Is it compulsory? Is your suffering compulsory? Or is suffering an option? What do you think, ladies and gentlemen? Is it a choice to suffer or not to suffer?
Here, Shiva, man.
Shivam Gautam.
Here, because we, if we born again, we have to suffer. There's no this thing. We can't escape from anything. So we have to suffer if we born as a human being.
So then, what is the use of you coming for these calls every day?
So we want to be one with divine, and we have to realize the truth of Neti Neti.
One of the main things that I guide you is how to be able to deal with suffering. But the question is suffering optional? Means, do you have an option? Do you have a choice to suffer or not to suffer? Okay, so Gautam, think about it. According to you, your very clear suffering is compulsory. Yes, Ashok Nijani.
Sir, there is an option.
Even though there is disease and despair around you, you feel there is an option?
There is an option. We should feel that my body is suffering. I am not suffering.
Very good. So is that how you are dealing with it now, Ashok? Are you? Would you like to share your current situation, or is it private? Would you like to share? I mean, who is not well, or what would you like to share?
Half the family is not well. Half the family is well.
Half the family has got COVID, is what you say, right?
Yes, sirji.
But are you suffering because of that, or you have chosen not to suffer?
We have chosen not to suffer. Don't think it is my
Great.
Body.
Excellent.
My body is suffering. I'm not suffering.
Excellent. I hope you're telling it from your soul, from your deep within your soul.
Definitely, sir. Sure.
Okay. So that is a great thing, Ashok, to hear from Ashok Nijani. Ashok Nijani says that suffering is an option. I choose not to suffer. People in his family have got COVID, but he said, people in my family have got COVID. The body is suffering, but I am not suffering. Amazing. Thank you, Ashok. But I'm still asking you the question, is suffering an option? Amitash.
May I, Guruji?
Yes, Master.
Mataji, I'm aapko bulayenge, Mataji. Amitash.
Master, I believe that suffering is optional, because if we choose to be absorbed in the knowledge, then we will not be suffering. We will be in ananda. However, if we are basically, we are trapped by this all the senses gratification, then we'll definitely be suffering.
But what if suddenly something like cancer hits, something like a heartbreak, something somebody
yes,
heart,
Master.
Your heart is shattered into pieces.
I would like to quote a very good example told by you long back. Told example of that I forgot the name. He's a very famous saint of Tamil Nadu. You came also to visit here once during the second wave. He's very thin. You told his name. I forgot. I'm sorry. Ramana Maharishi. Yes, yes. Huh. You quoted example of Ramana Maharishi when he was very sick. He told that body is suffering, but my atma, my soul is still with God, still very healthy. and I'm enjoying. So that's why. So this is basically a good example of showing that even after having physical illness, you know, pain of the body, we can still enjoy. We will not suffer.
Okay. There are many people who want to speak. I think, but we will give room, Mataji. She's one. Then all of you who are put your hands up, we will just give priority to room, Mataji. Bolo, Mataji.
Guruji, pranam. Guruji, when we think we are Ru, then it is an optional. When we think we are Ru, then nothing can trouble us, not body, mind, or ego. So it is option. If we can live as a observer and we witness this world, then definitely, I think, Ru agar apne aap ko samjhenge, toh optional hai.
Because the Ru doesn't suffer, right? The Ru doesn't suffer. The point is the body suffers pain, the mind becomes miserable, the ego becomes agonized. So let us understand.
Yes.
Thank you. Thank you for your deep answer. Sudeep Bhargava.
Shivam, sir.
Shivam.
So first of all, I would just mention Ashok uncle, his family recovers very soon and we meet all during the Shivratri celebrations again. So wish you all of you a very speedy recovery, sir. Second point, he talked about the suffering of the body. I would just like to add to it, the suffering of mind and ego also can be overcome by realizing that we are neither the body, mind and ego. So that is one way of overcoming the suffering. So it is an option. If I can realize that I am the soul, then I don't have to suffer the triple suffering of body, mind and ego.
Let me ask you a challenging question. You please continue. But yes, I'm dropping a challenging question. If you can overcome suffering of body, mind and ego, then my question to you is, why is 99.9% of the world suffering? But continue your talk and then you can think about this.
Sure. So another point is, sir, that which is a slightly proactive thing. The question that we have been answering so far is that we are suffer, that trigger point is already there and now we have to think whether we suffer or not. But another point could be that my today's karma will decide whether tomorrow I will suffer or not. So if I can do a good karma today, then maybe the suffering will not come at all. That's a more proactive step to even avoid the suffering, to even come face to face with me.
Yeah, but you know that if you do good karma, that you are going to come back, and when you come
yes,
back.
Yes, yes, yes. No, I have to come back, but at least I will come back in a good situation. So yeah, at least the suffering will be less, if not completely removed.
Good.
It can at least be reduced.
Agreed. Agreed, Sudeep. So I put a contract question to you. Karan Singh, it is in order, right?
Yeah. Yes, sir. Hello. Actually, hello.
Yes, go on, Karan.
Oh, sorry, I would have another one. Sir, when we activate our intellect, I feel so much anxiety and feelings. Like these feelings I could not control because I know everything. When I meeting people, I can say what people next will do. So therefore, I have little fear. I might not lose this experience or enlightenment experience, intellectual experience, I could say.
Okay, so you have to eliminate your fear, Karan. And whenever you speak, Karan, because there are 60 people on the call, please understand and speak loud and clear because we can't hear you otherwise. Then we cannot help you get the answer if you don't speak clearly.
Okay,
so please, we are not able to. I am having this problem. You must speak loud and clear whenever you want to speak. Thank you, Kaumudi, supreme immortal power. Bolo.
Yes. So I think that what life gives you or what events we have in our life is not in our hands, but how we responded to it and whether we take it as a victim and as a bichari and everything is happening to me, or to take it positively and say that, you know, I had this opportunity of learning something new or facing this thing or overcoming it, is a very positive sign. And I think it's a matter, it's a personal choice whether you want to be the sufferer or you don't want to suffer, although things are happening in your life.
So again, my question back to you, is suffering optional?
Yes, it is.
It's optional. So you can choose to suffer or not to suffer.
Yes, yes.
Okay. So nice to hear you all say that. Who else would like to go? Tanu. Tanu, is suffering option? I'm not sure. Amitash wants to ask again. Or Tanu,
Shivoham Guruji.
Shivoham.
Guruji, I wanted to say that suffering is optional only, because with the outer circumstances, our inner heart or inner soul should not be hurt. That should be like a tortoise only, that if something happens, it should be tough from above.
But tell me, how is suffering optional? Suppose it is today, optional today somebody comes and steals something very precious of yours. They steal it. Then you become unhappy. So how is suffering optional?
It is optional because the outer circumstances or outer world should not have any impact on our inner world. Inner world is different from the outer world.
So it looks like I'm speaking to a team of 50 enlightened people. So there's hardly anything to speak. Everybody in this chat is so enlightened. So now I don't know. Sometimes I really don't know what to speak or not to speak, right? Because all of you, it seems you have overcome all suffering. There is no pain of the body. There is no misery of the mind. There is no agony. One by one, please. I mean, you're right now, Tanu, you are having the mic. Kaumudi, wait. Tanu, kya bolna hai?
Guruji, but sometimes in real life, what happens that yesterday my finger came in the car door. And I screamed like anything.
So you suffered. So definitely you suffered, right?
And then I had do teen chakkar. So if in real circumstances, we cannot withstand that pain. So,
but tell me, did your spirituality help you to deal with that pain? Did your spirituality help you to say, this is only my body and I am not suffering? Did it help you?
I told this. Yes, I told this to myself.
Okay, good.
And now whenever I go to mall also, I always keep my eyes below only.
See, let me tell you one thing. We are a very small minority who's on this call, correct? We are a very small group. But the outside world is suffering day in and day out. The outside world is just going on a merry-go-round and they pass pleasure, pain, loss, gain, sun, rain, again and again and again. For people, suffering is not an option. You go and talk to the outside world, they say, no, suffering is compulsory. You go outside the Zoom call and talk to anybody, will they agree that suffering is an option? Will anybody agree to this? As Sanjay Das, will people outside agree that suffering is a choice? Will they agree?
No, sir. No, outside people. They don't know.
Outside world.
And let me ask you.
Bolo. Yes, Sanjay, bolo.
Yeah, Shivam Guruji.
Bolo, sir.
Yesterday, you told me today that accept and surrender, these two things which you told, really helped me out. And I discussed this with my family members and all. This was the best solution which I could get. Medicine is le rahe, naak bhi band ho raha hai, but you have to accept whatever is coming.
Excellent. And I hope it's helping you.
Sure. Yes,
I hope this is practically helping you, right? So, Sanjay, just since you like
that. The sound of my voice, you can make out, Guruji.
Yeah, of course, you're looking perfectly okay. You're sounding good, you're sounding healthy now. So, everybody on this call, if we learn to accept whatever happens, and then we learn to surrender to whatever will happen. The problem is what we are doing, my dear friends? We want to control what is going to happen. This is the biggest mistake. We want to control. We don't believe in this beautiful song. Que sera, sera, whatever will be. The future's not ours to see. Que sera, sera. The problem is, we don't surrender. We don't accept. Therefore, we resist. And when you resist, the misery will persist. The problem is that we don't know that this is a leela. This is a show. Today, I wrote some amazing quotes on happiness. You know, what did I write a quote? It's a quote which I wrote about 10 years back or 15 years back when I was not here. Tataji, have you heard this quote? The quote is this. If you can be glad, but you choose to be sad. If you can be glad, but you choose to be sad, then you are mad. Sanjay Das, you got it? If you can be glad, but you choose to be sad. Bridget, if you can be glad, but you choose to be sad, then you are mad. Because why are you trying to be sad when you can be glad? But some people, they just want this dose of misery. So, I want to argue, or throw this open to question. Girish, yesterday you had some profound question pending. Would you like to take that up, Girish, before I start this? No? You had a question,
Guruji,
yesterday.
Right? Guruji, Ashok ji is the best example today. Family is suffering and he is neutral. Good example is today in front of us.
Ru Mataji, because Ashok Nichani is in the realization that ye drama hai, leela hai.
Yes.
Ashok kya kar sakta hai? What can Ashok do? Ashok understands that nothing. Huh? Why worry? There is no need to worry. Why worry? There is no need to worry. Huh? No problem, then there is no need to worry. If there's a problem, there is no need to worry. He understands. What can you do? What is the use of being miserable?
Sirji, wife yes. is here.
Huh, wife is?
Wife here when he is here.
Wife here when he is
here. Wife here when he is here.
Prabhu paas hai. Prabhu paas hai. Prabhu paas hai. Prabhu. So today I'm starting a new bhajan CD. Ashok, it's called Insani Bhagwan. Today's new CD, I'm starting a new CD for this month of January. The title just came today evening. Insan hi Bhagwan hai. So the ruh, the soul is God. But we are searching for God. Okay, so my dear friends, let's take a little pause. This is a divine call because very few people who are lucky to be on this call, we live a life of bliss, of joy, of peace, of divine love. But most of the world doesn't understand this language. If you talk this language to people in the outside world, they think you're talking some nonsense. You're talking something crazy. Yeah, because they don't understand. They don't understand that suffering is an option. It is optional, which means that if you are suffering, it is your ignorance. You are permitting the pain of the body, the misery of the mind, the agony of the ego. You are permitting. You are permitting yourself to become agonized with anger, hate, revenge, jealousy. And you know what you lose? You lose the treasure of the present moment. You lose the great treasure, the greatest treasure of the present moment. And today some of the quotes I wrote were very interesting quotes. Every moment of life is a treasure to be well spent. Now, Bridget, every moment of life is a treasure to be well spent. We must not lose a moment intentionally or by accident. We must not lose a moment intentionally or by accident. Every moment of life is a treasure to be well spent. How many of us are spending this treasure called life? Moment by moment by moment. How can we live in the moment? Are we living in the moment? Our mind is pulling us to the past and we are thinking about what happened. Then our mind is putting us to the future. Oh, this should happen. This should happen. I will become happy if I get this. I will be happy if I am with so-and-so. I will be happy if I go to this place. No. Happiness is not about people, about places, about possessions. Happiness is a state of being. So, yes, we have many of you. Tanu said she jammed a finger in the car. Ashok Nichani says, I choose to be happy. Sanjay Das says, I learned the formula of accept and surrender. So this call, every day, we try to make life more meaningful. But remember, the final goal, my dear friends, the final goal is enlightenment. The final goal is to get to that state of Sat Chit Ananda. So how many of you are there? How many of you are facing challenges? We have 15 more minutes on the call. Over to you, Amitash, over to you, Amitash.
Am I audible, Master?
Little louder,
yes,
please.
Shivoham, Master, am I audible?
Yeah, little louder, I can hear you. Go ahead.
Okay, Shivoham, Master, my question is that, as you know, there is a third wave of corona coming. And I fear that there's a possibility, of death, and also I just wanted to know that is it possible to attain enlightenment or attain nirvana in a short frame of time?
Why do you think why do you think the corona third wave is going to attack you? Why is that thought in your mind, first of all? Why do you
Master, I have actually low immune system. That's why.
Okay, let me explain first thing to you, my dear friends. Amitash, especially you. Did you control your birth?
No, Master.
Did you control where you were born, whom you were born, when you were born? Did you control it?
Nothing, Master.
Remember one thing. You can't control your birth. You can't control your death. Once you are clear about this, you have to put this behind you, first of all. Please put this behind you. Don't start the whole media. Today I was just seeing the media has started now. Third wave, third wave, third wave. I think it's just going to attack. Third wave has become the new buzzword in the media today, from yesterday and today. If you don't die of COVID, you will die of heart attack or cancer or lung disease or kidney disorder. Or you will die out of a car accident or a plane accident. And if you escape this, I can guarantee you, you'll die when you sleep in your bed. So
yes, Master.
If you're scared of dying when you sleep in your bed,
No, Master, I'm not scared of death, Master. That is the only certain thing in life. I'm not scared of death, Master. I'm scared that I might die without attaining enlightenment. I want to attain as soon as possible.
So my point to you is this: first, you have to eliminate the fear of death. So first, the thought of death. Okay, I'm changing my word. I'm removing the word fear, because you say I have no fear of death. Remove the thought of death. The moment you are thinking death, correct? There can be no enlightenment. You know why?
Yes, Master.
Why can be no enlightenment? Because Amitash, you cannot die, Amitash. You are immortal.
You are
the supreme immortal power. You cannot die. Can I ask you a question? When you die,
yes,
right?
Please.
One day when your body dies, what will people say?
Yes, Master.
When your body dies, what will people say? People will say you are still in the body, or they will say you passed away.
Passed away.
So if you're going to pass away, then only the body will die, right? You don't die. You leave the body and you move on, right?
Yes, Master. I'm aware you took a lot of classes on that.
So understand the point that you will never die. First of all, be clear. The point is, if you want enlightenment, you can be enlightened today. You can be enlightened today, tonight, now, in the next 1 minute. You can be enlightened. If you are ready to let go of your body, mind, ego. The problem is you cling to the body. You cling to the mind. You cling to the ego. And you want enlightenment. It's just like saying, I close my eyes and say, I want to see. How can I see? If I'm closing my eyes, if I shut my eyes and say, no, I want to see. How can I see?
Yes.
You agree with me or not?
Yes, Master, I agree with you.
So don't close your eyes. Open your real eyes. If you Master, open your real eyes, you will see.
Master, when you say that you can get enlightened in one day itself, then this makes me ask one question. Is enlightenment something like on and off thing, like today I'm enlightened, but tomorrow I choose to be in Maya, or is it like that's it? If I'm enlightened, then it's like...
So I know somebody very dear to me who's enlightened, okay? I know somebody very dear to me, and that person is very enlightened. And although there are a lot of smiles of enlightenment, there is a wave that puts a kind of a veil or a chadar or a blanket on top of the enlightenment. So the enlightenment is there. But if you put a blanket on top of the enlightenment, the light goes off. I explained to Dasi Budrani the other day, for example, Amitash, I don't know you were there that day. Suppose you go into a dark godown where there are no lights. It's a godown of crystals and diamonds. And you think there's nothing in that room. And you switch on the light and you see all the crystals and the diamonds. Then you switch off the light. Will the vision of the crystals and diamonds go away?
No, it will not
go away, because you've already seen the crystals and the diamonds. You've already seen. Enlightenment is like that. You're already enlightened. But the mind मन ये दुश्मन बड़ा हमें सताता सदा मन ये द माइंड विल कम एंड द माइंड विल ड्रैग यू एंड मेक यू मंकी ऑफ यू एंड मेक यू गैलप लाइक द हॉर्स एंड देन यू आर गोइंग ऑन द रॉन्ग वे एंड व्हाट यू फील आई वांट टू एंजॉय फ्यू मोर इयर्स यू फील आई वांट टू एंजॉय फ्यू मोर इयर्स बिफोर आई बिकम एनलाइटेंड सो इफ यू आर लाइक दैट देन व्हाट आई कैन डू इफ यू वांट टू एंजॉय फ्यू मोर इयर्स बिफोर यू बिकम एनलाइटेंड व्हाट कैन आई डू टेल मी
Yesterday you told it is never enough.
Enlightenment is about now. Enlightenment is the biggest pleasure in this world. But we want pleasure bigger than enlightenment. You want a pleasure bigger than the biggest pleasure in this world. Then how can you get it? Can you get it? You can't get it. No, but you're chasing that shadow. You're running behind a shadow. And you think, oh, that shadow is so amazing. How can you be happy? So what I'm telling you, enlightenment is a moment of a spark coming on. When that spark comes on, many of you, like I was talking to you just now, the people have the knowledge. The people have the knowledge. People know it. People know it better than me. They know it better than me. But they are not enlightened. The knowledge is pakka. I'm telling you, there are very highly qualified people who know things 10 times more than I can tell you. But they do not let that become a realization. In realization, this, wow. So Amitash, the moment you get that enlightenment, you cannot lose that enlightenment. Until you don't get that enlightenment, you will always be ignorant. The crystal and the diamond will be looking at you, but you will think it's a stone because you can't see it. You will always be seeing something which is not. You are caught by an illusion. But the moment you are enlightened, for example, if I have realized the truth, Amitash, I can never leave it. I cannot let go of it. I hope you're getting what I'm saying. This is your question, right? What you wanted to ask me?
Yes, Master. Understood, Master. Thank you. Okay. Thanks.
Thank you. Next example, question, please.
Gave a lot of clarity that you said in the dark room. Thank you, Master.
I hope you got the clarity. Good. Next question, please. I have a question from Jyotri. Jyotri is our text questioner. What is the best gift, Prasadam, we can give to someone? It depends who you are and who you are giving to, right? If you ask me a question like this, the best Prasadam you can give to a person who's dying of thirst is water. The best Prasadam you can give to somebody who's dying of hunger is food. The best Prasadam you can give to somebody who's dying of ignorance is wisdom. The best prasadam you can give to somebody who's yearning for God is sip. So it all depends. But how can you give sip if you don't say, you yourself don't know the meaning of sip? So this is a question, is Jyotri. There is no best prasadam you can give to somebody. It all depends who is giving the prasadam and to whom you are giving the prasadam. There are many speakers in this YouTube and what's the many big gurus and swamis and speakers who talk big things, you know. But the point is they don't address the problem. The problem, my dear friends, is very simple. Life is a short journey. Is there any guarantee we will be awake tomorrow morning? Is there a guarantee that we will not? Why are we losing this moment? Why are we losing this moment, my dear friends? This moment is meant to be enlightened. Why are we not becoming liberated today and being united with the divine today when there is a possibility, when we can, when God has connected us to a group, to the Zoom call, where enlightenment is flowing like a tap, like a river? You can just fill a bucket of enlightenment and have a shower of enlightenment. But you stick on to your ignorance, you cling on to your attachments, and you want to be. How can, my dear friends, when life, we don't realize it? We see people who are like Puneet Rajkumar, 44 years gone. One Rishi at 60 odd years gone. We see, I have seen people at 35 years gone. No, when are we going to realize that soon we will be gone? Soon, why don't we realize? And otherwise we will come back. What we are forgetting, we will come back on this earth in a rebirth and we will suffer again and again and again and again. Why don't we realize the ultimate goal is to be, and the moment you reach that state of Jivan Mukta, when you reach that state of enlightenment, then every moment of life is a bliss. Every moment of life, you're free. You're free from misery of the body, misery of the mind, agony of the ego. Why don't we choose that? Questions, 5 more minutes to go.
Shivohamir.
Shivoha.
Today's option is suffering is optional. Actually, when we realize the truth of the life, that this is all a maya. So whatever happens to us, then why should we suffer?
Don't suffer. See, you are suffering. Suppose today, I believe I will be happy if I marry the most beautiful girl in Bollywood or the most beautiful girl in Hollywood. If I think I will be happy, then I'm trying to get to your thought, your frame of mind. If I think like that I will be happy only that day, then I will never be happy. No? I cannot be happy because I'm waiting for that day, and that day is never going to come. Because when that day comes, something else will happen. You think suppose I reach that day where I'm going to marry the most beautiful girl in the world and I become blind, then what happens? So we are trying to imagine that I will be happy in a tomorrow, not realizing that happiness is not in tomorrow. Happiness is in today. So Rekha, because we don't realize this, we are suffering today. We are suffering today because we are hoping to be happy tomorrow. Are kya bekufi hai? It is such ignorance, na? We are suffering. We are missing the happiness of today because we are hoping for the happiness of tomorrow. And every day we are losing today and today and today and today, and that tomorrow will never come. That's why they say, I have not told it thousands of years back, there's a statement, tomorrow never comes. Because when tomorrow comes, it will be today.
So now we know that this is all a maya. Why should we suffer? Suffering is not an option at all. We should not suffer at all, no?
That's what I'm telling. Don't suffer, na? But you are suffering, na? I know you are suffering.
Like, how I'm suffering?
You are suffering because you are seeking something which is a rainbow in the sky. Which does not, you cannot catch the rainbow.
I'm suffering to know this enlightenment.
Not enlightenment. We are slaves of the body, the mind, and the ego. We are, the body wants, the mind wants, the ego wants, the soul doesn't want. When my soul desires something, my soul is tript. Tript means my soul is content. That is the beauty. When you live as the soul, you're free from body, mind, and ego. We have been talking about this. The problem, Rekha, you have to live as the soul. Live as the Atma in Rekha. You also happen to be
there. I don't think I'm suffering. No, huh? What is suffering? I don't feel I'm suffering.
No, then there's no problem. Then why you ask, where's the question? The question only doesn't arise. If you are not suffering, then there is no question.
मतलब क्या है कि actually this is life ना, in life तो happiness and sadness comes and goes ना.
अरे अभी you're contradicting your previous point. You're saying there is no suffering. Now you're saying suffering, happiness and sadness comes and goes. Make up your mind, Rekha. Admit the fact. Admit that there is suffering or there is no suffering.
हाँ कभी कभी होता होगा suffering.
हाँ. I am Dasi Budrani. Dasi Budrani says, I am one with doctor and I am with the doctor, and he claims enlightenment is not in his knowledge. So therefore, you need to educate the world. Educate the world. Yes, Dasi, in fact, as I told you, 2022, after finishing writing 50 books, we have written 50 books. Our goal now is to take enlightenment to the world, because what I feel, people are being made fools. People are being taken for a ride. There are many people who are talking nonsense, and because enlightenment is not a subject known to this world, people are getting carried away and they're taking the wrong train because there is no right train. So they're all wrong trains and wrong planes and wrong buses going to the wrong destination. So there's a big problem. And therefore, I want your help. I want all of you to help me, because unless you all help me, how will we take this enlightenment message to the world? I want you all to help me. I don't mind giving you all books. I don't mind helping you in any way. But you should become the ambassadors. You should take this message, because this is your karma yoga. You should all take this message to the world, because people are suffering. The fact is people are suffering, people are crying, people are dying of cancer, of coronavirus, people are suffering body, people are suffering from depression. Big actors of big industries are industrialists. They are suffering out of thought of suicide. People are suffering out of anger, out of hate, out of revenge, out of jealousy. How jealousy comes in? Jealousy makes us so angry. I'll kill you. Why? Because we don't realize we are all one soul. If only the realization comes that you and me and everybody is part of one soul, where's the question of jealousy? Where's the question of anger? Where's the question of hate? This whole world is fighting wars. This world can have world peace if only the message of enlightenment reaches the world. But how does this message reach unless all of you also make an effort? I'm trying. We are working very hard. In the last 2 days itself, we have worked on many things. But we want to get to that point where the world sees enlightenment as an option. Right? No, people don't know the meaning of enlightenment. What Dasi is saying. What Dasi said, I'm with a doctor, right? And he doesn't know the meaning of enlightenment. So enlightenment is very simple, right? The enlightenment means to switch on the light. Dasi, what you should do, you should switch off the light. Dasi, switch off the light and tell the doctor, what can you see in the room? And the doctor will say, I cannot see anything. So tell my dearest doctor, if the light is off, you can't see. But how can you see inside if there's darkness inside?
Correct, you're right. So we are. I'm going to highlight, but he's not aware at all of what, you know, there's a different type of meditation and knowledge. So like me, I did not know enlightenment is such whereby we can evolve without having to come back to this world.
Dasi, that is the biggest challenge of life, Dasi. If we have to come back to this world, then we have failed. If we have to come back to this world, see, you may think this world has got a lot of pleasure, but you know the backside of the word pleasure is pain. You know it very well. You can't escape from pain. And Dasi, therefore, the biggest challenge in this world, not told by me, told by the sages 5,000 years ago, is moksha, is mukti. Told by Buddha 2,500 years ago is Nirvana. Told by the Christian saints that it is salvation and enlightenment and liberation. All these is one and the same. That we should become one with God. One with Sip. The super. You know, Dasi, a simple thing. How many people understand the meaning that God is not God? How many people understand? If you tell somebody, Dasi, God is not God, will they understand what you're saying?
God is not God. I don't know.
Because God is Sip, right? God is Sip, supreme immortal power.
Yes.
But they think God is Krishna and Shiva and Jesus and Ganapati and Lakshmi.
But the question is, I told somebody, they said, we are not pure. We cannot call Sip. We are the children of Sip. I don't know. That's why I sent you for clarification.
But Sip doesn't have children. Sip only has manifestations.
Yeah, right.
So the wave is not a child. The wave is not a child of the ocean. The wave is just an appearance of the ocean. You and me are not children of Sip, Dasi. We are Sip. You are Sip. But because if you think you are Dasi Budrani, how can you be Sip? Then you cannot be Sip.
You're right.
The moment we let go, then we realize Sip. My dear friends, I always tell you all, what happens is the first 5-10 minutes, we have a little starting problem. Then after 8:30, we get a lot of questions. So you all should be prepared for questions when we start the session. Just like I told Amitash, be prepared for enlightenment now. Because don't think there is tomorrow, my dear friends. And don't imagine happiness in something in a distant future. Make a vow to be happy in the now, moment by moment. To all you enlightened souls, I bow down to you and will see you tomorrow.
Thank you.